since Manila was bombed, ever since Bataan fell, ever since Corregidor was surrendered,
a particular group of soldiers in the United States Army has worked toward the day when their relatives in the Philippines will be delivered from the Japs and shall formally establish the Philippine Republic.
The 1st Filipino Infantry, which began with 8 men and 3 officers, expanded to full strength under Colonel Robert F. Offley, a West Pointer who grew up in the Philippines.
The regiment grew so fast, with volunteers from every part of the United States, that a 2nd Filipino Infantry Regiment had to be activated under Colonel Charles Clifford, who has seen years of service in the far Pacific Island. Idol of both regiments is West Point-trained Lieutenant Colonel Jaime Velasquez, battalion commander, who fought valiantly to the end as a member of General MacArthur's staff. The bitter lessons he learned on Bataan and Corregidor he now passes on. In the field, on maneuvers, working over and over to equip his officers and men with the training they are fiercely eager to master.
For these Americans are descended from people who have lost their native land, people whose one hope is the promise by the President of the United States. I give the Filipino people my word that the Republic of the Philippines will be established the moment the power of our Japanese enemies is destroyed.
The Filipino regiments use their spare time to learn extra things that will make them better soldiers than their hated enemy. For instance, radio. No one told them to study radio, but these men are coaching each other on their own time, sending, receiving, until they get it. And this is another voluntary session with the tough little GIs going over tactical problems. There's unbeatable spirit behind all this. Here's one sign of it. Discipline? Well, here's the guardhouse. Unguarded. When you feel like these soldiers, discipline is no problem. The 2nd Regiment has had only 4 prisoners in 6 months. Like any other Joe soldier, the Filipinos have their own lighter moments. A favorite pastime is sipap, a game with a kick in it. For a hot solo entertainment, the yo-yo stars come forward. This amusement, which swept America as a popular craze a few years ago, is a Filipino invention. Once the gadget is in motion, something pretty close to science steps in. Resourceful people, the Filipinos have other inventions, like this wooden traversing wheel, which applied in artillery practice often serves to... Oh, excuse it, please. This turns out to be a savory preparation for a lechon, or roast pig party. The porkers are roasted all through a night and a day. To the weapons of the GI American soldier is now added another, straight out of the national tradition of the Filipino. Here every man of the 2nd Regiment receives a bolo knife as part of his field equipment, the gift of a public-spirited group of Los Angeles citizens. For everything from hacking a trail through the jungle to close combat, the bolo is the national pride of the Filipino. He will now take it into battle for his enslaved people and for the United Nations. Maybe they are physically small men, these island soldiers, but armed with their inherited weapon and blazing with determination to do their utmost against the enemy they understand so well, they will be a mighty factor when we all go back under MacArthur. For they remember that no matter where MacArthur sets up his headquarters, he always gives his address as Bataan to keep faith with those who kept it there to the end. These U.S. Filipino fighting men have only one desire. It drives them at their work, and it gives them their motto, On to Bataan.